You know, they say a family that eats together stays together. So for a family that cooks together, that must be doubly true, right? In that case, Andrew, Irene, and Margaret Lee are stuck with each other. They're the sibling trio behind Mei Mei, which means little sister in Chinese, by the way. First a food truck, and now a casual restaurant near Kenmore Square. Mei Mei is known for American twists on classic Chinese favorites, like pierogi dumplings, sweet corn fritters, and scallion pancake sandwiches, like the Double Awesome. For the Lees, it seems like food and family go hand in hand, and now you can cook like they do with your family as well. They break it all down in a new cookbook of recipes they'd like to make together. It's called Double Awesome Chinese Food, Irresistible and Totally Achievable Recipes from Our Chinese American Kitchen. Two of the authors join me now, the littlest sister, Irene, who is a repeat James Beard nominee and now head chef at Mei Mei. Irene, it's great to see you again. Big brother Andrew, who founded the Mei Mei Group in 2011. Good to see you both. Welcome to two-thirds of the Lee siblings. Great
to
see you guys.
Thank
you.
Who
does what in this triumvirate? Like, what's the division of labor amongst the three of you?
Yeah, what do you do, Andy?
Well, my father used to say when he was training fellows at Dana-Farber, which is just in the Longwood Medical Area here, he said that his plan was to find the best and brightest in his field and then to get out of their way.
So is that what you do?
It's exactly what I've done.
And you found your sisters?
My plan has come to fruition. Irene's taking care of most of the operations now, and she's put together a great team. We're very fortunate to have the support that we do.
Raise your right hand and tell me what it's like to work. You have to swear this is the truth and the whole truth. What's it like to work? He raised his hand. What's it like to work with your siblings?
It's a gift and a curse.
Oh, you were honest.
Yeah,
okay. Well,
yeah.
Tell me a little bit about both.
Well, I think, you know, for me, I'm 8 and 9 years younger than my big brother and big sister. So for them to even be interested in moving back to Boston and working on a project together was a big deal for me. And I think, you know, despite some arguments that we may have had, some differences in style, they trusted me as the chef to do things that no sane business owner ever would have or should have.
And that's
so
a beautiful family story.
I think I owe so much of, you know, the lovely attention that I've received to them and their belief in me.
Is it fair to call this Chinese-American food? I'm always nervous when I have people like you on that I'm going to do. Is it, I mean, that's Chinese-American food?
I suppose.
What do you mean you suppose? It's
best.
Your food. What is it?
Well, you know, it's a raging debate, actually.
Inside,
outside, wherever we go, really.
Yeah.
So what would you call it? If I hadn't said Chinese-American, what would you call what you do, Andy? What would you say it is?
Just add cheese.
Speaking of, is this the Double Awesome right
this
here?
This is indeed, yes.
Which I've had many a time, I should say. When you look at this, you don't think Chinese-American. I think it's cheddar, eggs, pesto, if I recall, cheese on a scallion pancake. Is
yes.
that right?
You're an expert.
Well, I've had it a lot of times. Right? Can I bite while we're doing
oh,
this?
Please
oh,
do.
Please.
Keep
yeah.
talking, please, while you're doing this. Yeah.
Well, I think that what we cook to us is, it's really just food. It's the kind of stuff that we grew up eating. It has Chinese influences. It has influences from New England and the Northeast. And it's really just what you come up with living in our house, maybe scrounging for an afternoon snack.
What sets you apart? I mean, there are a ton of Chinese-American restaurants in town. What makes this one different from some of the others, would you say, Irene?
Well, I think one of the most fun things that we get to do is really focus on New England and the Northeast and the ingredients that you find
here.
Yeah,
you're a big locally sourced kind of person,
I'm all about
right?
the farms, yeah. And so, for example, we use maple syrup in a soy ginger sauce. We take really tart Massachusetts cranberries and use that as the acidic component in a sweet and sour sauce. So for us, it's really fun to see how we can mix and match items from the Northeast with sort of classic Chinese flavor profiles.
What is this thing, by the way?
So these are our sweet corn fritters, decidedly, I would say, American. But
can I use my hands while
oh, please do. Yes, that's what we recommend.
What am I dipping it in?
You are dipping it into a creamy maple dipping sauce.
Of course I am. Go ahead.
And one of the things we love so much about these sweet corn fritters is that we actually use frozen corn, which for a lot of chefs might seem a little unseasonal. But for us, because we're so interested in supporting local farms and making sure that farmers have income all year round, we found this incredible group that we can buy this seasonal product from, but all year round. And so we can have a consistent product
classic
on the menu.
Classic Chinese American.
Exactly.
Corn fritter. Exactly.
Yep.
Okay, so the cookbook, Double Awesome, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It is family stories, which I have to say I love the most in this thing. Great family stories and recipes. For those of us who are occasionally cookbook phobic, and I have those moments, how is this going to get me by that?
Well, one of the nice things about the cookbook is that it starts in a progression from, you know, sauces and other very simple recipes that are a little bit more approachable. And then it goes into the more complicated things. But I would say to anyone that does us the honor of trying to cook or attempting one of the recipes, we're going to love however it turns out. You know, we're going to support however it turns out, whatever you decide to change, whatever you think makes it taste better. And as long as you have fun doing it, you know, bring your family in, have a couple drinks in the kitchen or whatever. Then, you know, we feel like we've done something special, and we're just really, really honored and feel very grateful.
You know, there are a million great stories in this book, and I'm sure you're sick of telling this one, but this is the best by far. So your mother goes to Jamaica.
Yes.
For a short period of time. And you do what any kid would do
exactly.
When her mother left town, which was what exactly, Irene?
I bought a 200-pound pig and had it delivered to my mother's home.
Exactly.
It was already dead, and then we butchered it in her kitchen.
Why wouldn't you?
Exactly. Why wouldn't you?
Exactly.
Yeah, it's just, you know, standard.
And what was the thinking exactly when you decided to do it? What were you saying to yourself when your mother left town?
So our thought was, we really believe that animals should get to live their lives outside. It's good for the animals, it's good for the humans who take care of them, and it makes the meat taste really good. So in order to afford that really high-quality pork, we thought, you know, we can't afford $17 a pound for a pork chop.
Of course not.
If we buy the whole pig and we can get $3 or $4 a pound, hey, you know, maybe that's how we can make this work.
Before you leave, Food Waste Feast, is that what the thing is called?
Yes.
I love this thing. Quickly tell people what you do, and I've used it. It is great.
Oh, that's so wonderful.
No, it is great. Tell us quickly.
So Food Waste Feast is a blog that primarily is written by our sister, and it's organized in such a way that if you have something, you know, dying in the back of the refrigerator, you can type the name of that ingredient into this blog and find some really great recipes, or they're really guidelines for how to take that ingredient and turn it into something that, you know, your family will be excited about eating, even if it's leftovers.
It's fabulous. Well, the cookbook is great, the website is great, and I love the restaurant too. It's great to see both of you guys. Say hi to your sister. Andy, it's great to see you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks so much, Irene.
Thanks for having us.
Really appreciate it. The cookbook again, and it is doubly awesome, is Double Awesome Chinese Food, Irresistible and Totally Achievable Recipes, or at least so they say, from our Chinese American Kitchen.